Ottawa's got a ton of them. They're all going to go over to the Worlds. Bottom line is goaltending, again, is the most important position of any sport. If your goaltender gets hot like Cujo has been in this series, he's capable of winning a series on his own. He did it game one against Ottawa. He did it a couple years ago for Edmonton against the mighty Dallas Stars. And he's capable of beating any team, anywhere, anytime. Can he do it against New Jersey, who they'll probably play in the second round? I don't think that New Jersey is weak enough and will compete a lot harder than the Ottawa Senators did. Cujo will see a lot more traffic in front of him. He'll see a lot more bodies going down the wall. He'll see a lot more people going to the front of the net than he has against the Ottawa Senators. Is he capable of beating New Jersey? Yes. Do I think he will? No. I think New Jersey will beat Toronto in a hard-fought series, but Cujo's capable of making it tough.
All right, speaking of the Devils, Martin Brodeur going for his third straight shutout. That hasn't happened in the playoffs since Frank Ulster's McCool did in 1945. Ronnie Francis, concussion, will not play. Fans thinking of him and not liking him. Public enemy number one, Scott Stevens. First period, very early in, 2 minutes in. Sammy, how I love ya. 1-0 Canes, Barry Kapanen scores.
Well, for this team to get going with Francis out of the lineup, somebody's got to start playing. Sammy Kapanen carried them all year long. He has not had a great playoffs. Got the goal early.
Jason Arnott ties it at one on the 5-on-3. Barry, is Archer's Herbe the new enforcer for the Canes?
Well, again, if a goaltender is going to go out and run into people, you should be able to hit a goaltender when he leaves the net. We protect those guys way too much.
Stevens at it again, Barry.
Comes across, Sammy Kapanen gets leveled. This is how Stevens plays, folks.
The professor doesn't like it. Second period, Hurricane power play. David Tanabe can bring it, people. He makes it 2-1, Parham. And Larry Robinson doesn't like this turn of events.
No, he doesn't. The Devils were sloppy and undisciplined. Colin White takes a terrible penalty here, and Larry's going to let the boys know on the bench that that's not acceptable. First game in the series, the Devils have kind of come unglued.
Devils pressing. McGillneyall, nice shot, but a better save by Herbe. And then some tough news here. Scott Niedermeyer left the game. The knee not feeling well. We hope it's not serious. Third period, Devils shorthanded. They're down by a goal. Going for the sweep. Peter Sikora, twisted wrister. Ties it in two. Second of the playoffs, Ray. More problems for New Jersey.
Again, New Jersey was sloppy. You don't see Scott Stevens do this very often. Great chance for Daniels in the slot, but Brodeur is able to make the save. And here Vasilchuk comes in the slot. He makes splits of defense at Stevens again and Rafalski. But again, Brodeur, best game of the series for him.
In overtime, Kapanen, that's a shot slash pass. And Rod Brind'Amour wins the game. Canes win 3-2. They're not swept, Barry.
Two best players on the ice, Kapanen and Brind'Amour. It's fitting that they combine for the winning goal. Great pass by Kapanen to Brind'Amour, winning the battle in front of the net.
What lead singer Stuart Adamson was to Big Country, Rod Brind'Amour is to the Canes. Devils lead 3-1. Brind'Amour said afterwards, quote, it's a big hill to climb, but this is fun now. Devils get a power play goal, snapping their franchise record 5 straight playoff games without a power play goal. They've lost 8 of their last 9 playoff overtime games. Brind'Amour, what a great game for him, and the Hurricanes snap their 6-game playoff losing streak. So there will be a Game 5, and it will be Friday night on ESPN. 7.